I've got a bit of a soft spot for steamrollers. Got quite a few in my collection. This one is made by Bing. I'm not sure if it has a model number, but the model has a name, Pluto. Comes from around 1902, in a period when Bing were naming their models, usually with some sort of classical connotations. Pluto, I think, was named after the god rather than the dog. I don't know how much water this takes. It's the first time I've steamed it, so I'm doing my usual filling it up to the top and then removing about 30%. This seems to be quite a large boiler. Right, that's about the top, so it's about 300 mil. So I remove about 100 mil. Leaving 200 mil. Now the burner is a little tricky to get at. It's clipped under the cab here, a pair of clips. The same procedure applies here. Put it to the top and remove 30%. Again, it seems to be a very large tank. So that's about 75. So if I remove about 30, 25. About 50. Spilt a bit of a mess, quite a bit there, so it would be a good idea to mop some of that up. Now comes the tricky bit, fitting this back in the engine without spilling in it. That was easier than I thought. Okay. Incidentally, I'm running this, or I will be running this, on a homemade rolling road consisting of some Meccano and a pair of rollers made from a plastic tube and four ball bearings. Which incidentally come quite cheap nowadays on eBay, from China of course. Running quite well. Nice fancy Bing Pluto there, embossed onto the spoiler end cap. Thin whistle seems to blow water rather than steam. It has an interesting reversing mechanism, operated by a lever in the pack here. The crank seems to have come loose on the crankshaft. Oh well, have to fix that then. Okay, so the problem was that the crank here is a screw fit on the crankshaft, and when I put it into reverse it's unscrewed itself. Not exactly the best of ideas. So I've tightened it up. There isn't room for a lock nut, unfortunately. So I've applied a drop of Loctite, left it for a couple of hours to harden, and we'll see if it's fixed or not. Okay, so it's running happily in forward, which is no surprise. So what happens when it puts in reverse. The Loctite wasn't enough. Okay. So we'll have to just run it in forward for the moment. The wheels are a bit wobbly. They're just made out of tin plate, bent round and joined. Not a casting like the modern ones are. So, the whole thing shakes. Which of course doesn't help the screws on top, like the crank. Okay, just out of curiosity, let's see if we can get any more success with this thing. Seems to be okay as long as you don't turn it too far. Okay. It's been a lot worse than that. Unfortunately, there's no throttle or any form of speed control, so it's full steam ahead. It should be a bit like the Mammoth, isn't it? Very high speed. Okay, I'm not having much luck here. Not only did the crank come loose, but the flywheel itself then came loose. And that's not even a threaded fitting, that's a push fit, a press fit. So it was another job for Loctite. I'll try again. Well, she's running again, and in both forward and reverse, although I still don't trust the reverse 100%.